So welcome back to the channel World of Techies. So today the implementation that we are seeing is for a very basic WebSocket. So first of all, like, what exactly is a WebSocket? So WebSocket is we commonly use the REST APIs, which is like working in a request response manner, when like the client sends a request and the server processes the request and sends a response back, right? So it is, we all know, like, this is like a stateless protocol. Like, basically, I mean, the client sending the request and the server server processes it and sends it back, right? So we are not maintaining the state of the request, right? I mean, every new request has to carry all the necessary information for the server to be able to process this request, right? While WebSocket is a different thing. So WebSocket works in a like a full duplex or a bi-directional model. Therein, like, what happens is that unless in the REST API model, wherein like the client has to like re-establish the TCP connection every time it is trying to interact with the server, in the WebSocket, what happens is that once the TCP connection is established between the client and the server, it remains active until one of them terminates the connection, right? So you can think of it that it is like a tunnel. Once that tunnel is established between two entities, then they can just exchange the messages without any problem, like no constraints there. Say for example, the server wants to send a message to the client, they'll be able to. So this is a very basic diagram showing how that happens. So for example, like, that client initiates the connection to the server, and then the server, like, once it has established the connection, then they can like exchange the messages bi-directionally, which means is that, say, if at any point of time, if the server wants to send a message to the client, he can also send. Like, it is not that only when it receives a request from the client only then it will send something to the server. Whenever, say for example, if server has anything to be communicated to the client, even in that case it can do that, right? Now think of some practical example where this is useful, right? So like WhatsApp or Slack and all these like chat applications, right? In these applications, as soon as, for example, like, you are online, the server will push you all the new messages that are coming in, right? And say for example, like, you are chatting with one of your friend, right? You send him a message and then he sends you a response, right? One way is that you will keep polling the server, asking him, hey, do you have any new message for me? Right? But the other way could be that the server intercepts that, okay, there's a new message for you, and it automatically pushes the message to you, right? So this is like a push mechanism, wherein like server gets a message, server pushes the message to the client. It does not wait for the client to poll for the message, right? So that is why, like, I'm saying that this is a bi-directional tunnel. If the server wants to send you anything, it will send without you sending the request, right? And similarly for the client, if the client wants to send anything to the server, they can send without any constraints, right? Another good example of this is like the applications like ESPN and CricBus, wherein like they constantly send you the updated score, right? So as soon as, say for example, there is any change in the score, it is not that the client has to keep polling, okay, is the new score, is there any change in the score, is there any new score that I need to update, right? So that does not happen. As soon as, say for example, like Virat Kohli hits a six, the server says that, okay, this is the updated score, Virat Kohli has hit a six, it was, say for example, on the long off or whatever it is, right? And the server can just like provide the updated information to the client without having the client to actually ask for it, right? So that's the basic of like the theory of how WebSocket works, right? So now we'll look at the actual implementation of a bi-directional WebSocket. First of all, a disclaimer that the implementation that we are seeing now, it is not like a production level code. It is a very basic prototype that I've developed to try and learn more about the WebSockets, right? So it kind of establishes the connection between the client and the server, does some basic communication, and that's it. Like, no error handling, nothing, the synchronization issues and all, they might be existing, right? So it is not what I'm saying that like it is a really good production level code and you can just directly use it, right? You'll have to work upon it if you are planning to reuse it, right? So let's take a look at that, right? So this is like our bi-directional a WebSocket solution, right? So this is the client side of code and this is the server side of code, right? Let's take a look at the code once, right? It's a very basic implementation. There are just like, I mean, if you look at it, it is hardly like 70 lines of code for the server and similarly like 60 lines of code for the client, right? And there are like very basic concepts that I have used. Like, one is definitely the WebSocket and then the second is threading, right? So now let's take a look at the code, right? So what we are doing here is that we are just like establishing the, we are just like creating a port, the server socket, right? And then we basically allow the server socket to start accepting the connections from the client, and we are running this in an infinite loop so that like the server can keep accepting the connections and all, right? And then we are running two separate threads, one for sending the message, one for receiving the message, right? So this is, as I mentioned, like this is like this, the example that I've tried to implement is a bi-directional like protocol, right? It's like a full duplex communication that we are trying to establish, right? So that is why we are using two separate threads, one for like receiving the message, one for like sending the messages, right? And then there's a very simple thing. So what we are doing here is that the messages that the server send, they will be intercepted on the client side, and the client will store these messages on a text file at its end, and similarly the server will intercept the messages from the client and it will store in the text file on its side, which is on the file called like server.txt, right? So let's take a look at the code in action. Okay, let's first take a look at the client as well, right? So what a client is doing, like again, client is also starting two threads, one for the sending, one for the receiving, right? And client is also like, I mean, once the port is open, then the client will try to establish the socket to the server and all. It's a very simple code, right? Nothing, no fancy thing, a very basic library, very basic implementation of threading to do the implementation, very simple function to just write the messages to the file. Let's see the code in action. So the server is listening now. Let's start the client as well. Okay, the client is also listening, right? Now let's try to send a message to the client, right? So the client has intercepted the message, it has now processed the message, it has written that message to a file. Now let's try to send a message from the client. Cool, the client is also able to send the message. Now let's say that now the server sends some message. Now say that the client wants to send a message, I'm looking for the latest cricket score. Let's reload this file. Cool. Okay, now say that the server wants to send a message. If we ignore the language, ignore these like typo errors, that is fine, like don't judge me on that. Okay, let's say the current score is 354/5. Let's see now the client was able to process this or not. Cool, the client now knows the score, right? Now it is not necessary like the client has to acknowledge or something, that is completely fine. Client just processed the message and then it showed on the web browser or the app, wherever it wants to, that is fine, right? Now say that the server wants to send another message. Just hit a 6 on long on. The new score is 360/5. Now let's see, let's reload. Cool, so the client now knows that okay, there was a 6 that was hit and it has updated the new score as well, right? Now it is not just like this is a completely one-sided, even the client can send a message. So say for example that's a client can say it's been 5 minutes, no update in score. Right, so let's go to the server side. Server will say it is drinks break. Cool, that's fine. So the client knows that okay, there's a drinks break going on, so that is why there is no update in the score. So that is how it is, that this is a very simple implementation of the client of the WebSocket on for both the client and the server side. The code is available on GitHub. I'll also like share the link of the code in the description. Hope you like this. So I mean, there's a recent thing that I've learned from Arpit Bayani. So he keeps saying that system design is not just about like building the blocks. Even a 4-year kid it can just create the blocks, right? It is about the implementation. So that is what like I'm trying to attempt now, to go deep into the implementation, building big and small prototypes, scaling them and all to make them like bigger applications. That is what I'll try to do from now on. So hope you like this video. If you like it, like do suggest me like what we can do further. If you have any interest in like contributing to this project, feel free to do that as well. It's on the Git only. You can just like push in like create a pull request and all, and I'll try to see like if it is worth exploring. One more thing that I'll try to recommend, like if you're trying out this code, see like if you remove this sleep, what happens, right? So I've like put in all these sleeps on the both on the server and client side. See if you remove the sleep, what happens to the code. So cool. I hope you like this video. I hope you like this as a good initial tutorial. If you have any doubts or if you feel that the video was too fast, too slow, there were certain more parameters that we should have covered and all, feel free to leave a comment. I'll try to address them. And let's hope, let's continue the learning. Cool. Okay. Thanks. Bye-bye.